Hi guys, it's me, Trudy Lee. How you doing? Today is Sunday, September 13th. Wow, almost 2 weeks into September, you guys. We're almost halfway over with September. Unbelievable how the days go by so quickly. It's crazy. This past week was a beautiful week for us here. All the way deep down in South Texas, we had a cold front, so it was beautiful. I had my windows all open. They were nice and gorgeous cool breeze coming in for like 2 days, and the air conditioner's back on now. And I think in the last video, somebody said what was going on. I have a ceiling fan, but it's not turned on when I'm doing a reading. But I had my windows open, and maybe a breeze came and blew it, and it was slowly turning a little bit. So somebody said, "What is those things above your head?" I think it was the fan, but I don't ever turn it on when I'm reading. Okay. So that's the answer to that. Big mystery there. Again, it's hot. It's, you know, getting up there. And I think it's going to be in the 90s. It's not going to be in the hundreds. So that's good. So we had record cool. I mean, it was super cool, y'all. It was so nice. It was like 57 degrees in the morning here. It was gorgeous. Absolutely beautiful. But it's done. It's over with. We're going back to the warm weather again. But that's South Texas for me. Now I have a lot of allergies from having the windows all open. All the pollen, everything has all come in, and now I'm choking. So I'm paying the price for it, but I enjoyed it anyway. What I wanted to look at today was Donald Trump and that Woodward's book, Rage, to see if that's going to, you know, is that going to bring Trump down? That's really what I want to look into. But before I get into that, you guys know I like to do a little talking, so bear with me. If you're new to my channel, welcome, and I like to talk about my life and what's going on. I've been doing a lot of portal closings for people, so if you'd like to do a portal closing, please email me down below. I can do it on the people in your house, yourself, and your home, everything, get everything, all the energy flowing good and open good energy portal flows in your home. So last night I sat down to do that. I had a lady that had asked me, and I came into my room here. And of course, I have all kinds of stuff all over the place. Y'all can't see everything. This is my desk, but it's full. I do Etsy, I do eBay, I do everything. I had a package here ready to go. That I had sold. I hadn't closed it up yet. I had the package open, but it was ready for the label to go on it. There was a big old scorpion sitting right on top of the package. I was like, oh my God, on top of my desk. I'm like, oh my God, I've killed it and threw it away, you know, poor thing. I have a deal with insects. If you come into my house, you die. Okay, so you're taking your chances. Anyway, I'm so glad that it didn't get inside the package. Imagine if somebody opened up a package and a scorpion came out. So now I'm never going to leave my packages open. I'm going to seal them right away. As soon as I put it in, I'm going to seal it. What if it would have been terrible. Anyway, gosh, if you order something from me, you might get a surprise. Anyway, you might hear some banging and some saw being, you know, turning on outside here. My husband is out on the porch here. He's building himself, I don't know, a bed thing to lay on. In Iran, they like to go and lay on beds outside on the deck and stuff. They always have like a big bed to lay on with big pillows and everything. He had one before, and, you know, he had built it out of wood. And after a while, you know, the wood goes bad. So we had burned it, I think, a long time ago. So he's building himself another one now because he says he likes to, when it's cooler, because it's turning to fall, to go outside and be able to lay under the stars and look at the stars. In Iran, a lot of times they will go out on the rooftops. All their roofs are made flat, and they'll go out on the rooftop and sleep outside in the cool air. And they used to do that at night when, you know, he was a kid and he was at home. They would sleep on the roof. And so he remembers, you know, staring at the stars and all that. And he has good memories. And he always tells me, I want to go sleep outside. And I'm like, there's scorpions in the house. Do you really want to sleep outside? Go ahead. And I just tell him, go ahead. There's, you know, whatever crawls on you, you deserve it. There's lizards. I mean, we live out in Boulevardy. We live in the country, you know. We only have like 3.5 acres here. It's not that big, but there's not that many houses around here. So there's all kinds of things crawling around. And there's, you know, raccoons, possums, rats, what else? Skunks everywhere. There's all kinds of, oh, porcupines. My dog got into a porcupine. You don't want to be out there at night going to sleep. I don't think so. No, I don't think so. A big old rat might crawl on you. I don't know. But if he wants to, more power to him. Let him do it, you know? Anyway, my son-in-law came over and helped him cut some of the wood for that yesterday. So I got to see my son-in-law and my grandson. My 13-year-old grandson came with him. So I went to Shipley Donuts and bought donuts and kolaches and chocolate milk and everything. Had everything all ready for them. Grandma always has to, you know, have something good to eat. And I've been wanting to go to this new Shipley Donuts that just opened up here in Boulevardy. So that was a good excuse to do that. So I got me some kolaches. Their kolaches are huge, man. They are huge. I was thinking a little kolache. I remember I used to buy kolaches for my daughter's class. Remember in kindergarten, a mother would have to bring the snacks once every so often. I would always get kolaches, but they were small. This kolache was this big. I was like, oh my God. I got it with jalapenos. It was good. It was good. It really was a lot of bread though. All right, guys. So sorry for me prattling on. I'm gonna go ahead and start this reading and start talking about Donald Trump. So I'm just asking my spirit guides, will, you know, that Woodward's book, is it gonna help bring Donald Trump down? And what I'm getting here is has a detrimental effect on him, but as with everything with Trump, he's able to keep his head above the water. He's just able to keep his head above water. Somebody step on his head, please, please. But that's what I'm getting. But also the White House, their reaction to the tapes, it's like it's put like a dynamite on their butt. It's like a firecracker. They are ignited into action and they're putting out all their surrogates. They're putting them out on talk shows. They're going full force. Even Giuliano is starting to come out and talk again. You know, we haven't seen much of him lately, but of course, you know, he was the mayor of 9/11, so he's making the rounds because it was 9/11. God bless all the people that lost loved ones and in 9/11. But he was out talking, so they wanted to use him too. So they used him, you know, as a rebuttal to the things that we hear in Woodward's tapes. Okay. But what I'm getting from my spirit guides is this is casting a shadow over Trump's presidency. Does it bring him down completely? No. But it is a big dark shadow. That's what I'm seeing. Big dark shadow is cast over his presidency for sure. Okay, so we'll take what we can get, right? We'll take what we can get. you know, I know a lot of y'all have probably heard some of the tapes that are being played. Evidently, there's a whole lot of tapes. There's a bunch of tapes because he interviewed Trump like 18 times, I think, and I'm sure you heard that, you know, Trump decided to downplay the coronavirus, that he said, you know, he knew how deadly it was, that it was worse than the flu and that it was airborne and everything. And he downplayed it. He completely lied to the people. How horrible is that? I don't understand how you could support Trump and think that was okay to lie to the people. And even now, still trying to get people packed in stadiums and everything to come and rally for him, you know. He just doesn't care about people. He doesn't care. He just does not care. And the sooner people will understand that, the better off everybody will be. I read about the book. You know, I read a few things about the book. I haven't gotten the book yet myself. But Trump was shown a video from Netanyahu when he went to Israel. Not Netanyahu showed him this video about the Palestinian leader ordering the murder of children. And then Rex Tillerson was there. When Netanyahu left the room, Tillerson told him, that's just a manipulated video. That's not real. That's words strung together. He didn't really order, you know, the murder of children. That's not real. And Trump's like, yeah, it is real. I saw it myself. It's real. You know, he wouldn't believe his own, you know, head of security. He wouldn't believe Rex Tillerson, but he'll believe this fake video, you know. And then, like, he pulled all the funding from the Palestinian territories within that year. That's what I read. So Trump is so easily manipulated. It's so scary to have, you know, a leader like Trump that can be manipulated so easily. It's just so scary. And, you know, that Netanyahu, he's up on corruption charges right now, you know. So anyway, he won't listen to any of, you know, the national security experts and advisors. He won't listen to anybody. He makes up his mind about things, and he'll listen to gossip, you know. Somebody will whisper something in his ear or show him a fake tape or something. He listens to that, but not to his experts. He's crazy. He's a crazy guy. We don't need this kind of person in office. You know, he was so sure that he was going to have such a great relationship with that Kim Jong-un. There's so many love letters in the book and everything. I think 25 love letters that are printed in that book. But James Mattis, he was so worried that we were going to be attacked by North Korea that he slept in his clothes. That's how freaked out and worried he was. And then, you know, he ended up leaving. I mean, how can anybody have peace with this man and want him as our president? I don't understand. I really, really don't understand. Okay, so let me pull some cards on Trump. And are these tapes going to bring Trump down? Are these tapes going to bring Trump down? Let's take a look at this. Okay. Ace of Pentacles. Well, these tapes are actually, they're a gift. They're an opportunity, plain and simple, for Trump to stop Trump from being reelected. So it's a good opportunity, you know. And like I said, I saw this big old shadow being cast, so it cast a shadow of doubt. So it's a good opportunity, you know, for us to stop him from being reelected. People, listen to it. It's a gift. Listen, people, listen to the tapes. It's Trump in his own words saying these things. Three of Pentacles. So it looks like to me this means that, you know, the tapes contribute to bringing Trump down, but it's not like, it's not the total nail in the coffin. It's like there's so many factors involved, you know, many different sources, many different factors. It's a concerted effort, you know, working with others. So it's a concerted effort to bring Trump down, but it's not the only thing. But it's going to help. It is going to help bring him down with others. And there's a woman here. Now, we've been hearing about this woman. This is the woman that helps bring Trump down, okay? And she keeps showing up here. She has a big hand in bringing Trump down. Maybe it's Nancy Pelosi. You know, I know she's been trying for sure. She really has tried hard. Ace of Cups. This is the last card I pulled. You know, the pain of the past 4 years with Trump in office, you know, has really hurt and damaged this country. But I feel like this is gonna end. That's what the tears are all about. All the pain and damage and hurt that Trump has caused. This is an opportunity for us to, you know, get him out of office, move past this, and it does help bring Trump down. It won't by itself bring him down, but it will help. It's one more nail in his coffin, okay? So it's another opportunity to shed light on who Trump really is, you know, what's really going on in his mind, what he's thinking about and all, it will bring to light all these things that, you know, people know, they know it, but it's like, you know, it's like the Trumpsters, it's like banging your head against the wall to make them see the real Trump, you know, but they can hear it. So it's gonna help bring him down. Won't totally, you know, on it in its own, it's not gonna bring him down, but it is gonna help. Okay, that's what I see here. All right, guys, thank you for listening to me. I know I went on and on in this video. You know, I'm a talker, but I appreciate y'all tuning in to me. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for all your comments. I do try to read a lot of them and all of them, even if I don't comment back. I do, you know, they come across my phone, so I'm able to read them and take a look at them. Thank you so much. I hope y'all are having a blessed Sunday. Please keep all the people in Oregon and Colorado, California. There's fires in so many different states. Keep them in your prayers. And I hear there's a bunch more hurricanes on the way. It might be coming in our neck of the woods over here too. So you guys, keep people in your prayers. Keep your thoughts pure. Don't focus on the negativity. Focus on the happiness. I know y'all can probably hear that. That's my husband drilling screws into his little bed. Thank you so much for tuning in. Again, I love you guys. Y'all take care. Do something kind for somebody. It'll always come back to you. Bye for now.